Colleagues, please hear welcome for your word for this documentary.
Доброго дня, шановні пани та панове.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, you know that we are here together for the purposes of presentation of a very special full-scope project, a documentary, Maidan story. When we hear this notion of the Maidan, we have creeps. I also get creeps when I remember that, because I lived through the whole period as the anchor, stage presenter. It was typical for everyone, for disabled people, for those people who were too weak to join but were in front of the TV. And that is why, indeed, this topic is going to be highlighted on numerous occasions, maybe in the future, in the faraway future that will be rethought, reexamined, reinvestigated. This is such a unique, such a special event, full-scope analysis. We are not capable at this point, no social worker, no social scientist, no psychologist, even creative person cannot do that. But creative people, artists can see this event and the emotion and the truth, the genuine character. I would like to thank you, because I understand that many media groups provided materials for the documentary. I haven't seen it myself, and I cannot discuss the contents because of that, but it is by all means important, because at this point we have to do it for Europe, for the world. We need the right coverage of this information. It should be truthful, because it's not a secret that at the times of information war, the aggressor, the Kremlin propaganda, they are distorting all these events because of their big capabilities, means that великий вплив і навіть на європейські СМІ, і на світові, нам дуже важливо, щоб шановані люди, кінематографісти, it's very important for us, for the high-profile filmmakers, to
дуже важливо, щоб була показана та емоція,
deliver the truth about the Maidan, the emotion, the pain, the heroism, the losses that we had in the course of these events.
Не бачивши
фільму,
але відчуваю, з якою щирістю
відбувається
підхід до цього. Я дуже радий, що тут присутні представники Київського патріархату, Української православної церкви, які стояли в ті часи, які молилися за Україну, дуже символічно, що фільм має назву «Молитва за Україну».
It's called a prayer.
Ця молитва продовжує.
It's symbolic, because the prayer is ongoing.
Майдан має три крапки.
And Maidan is not yet finished. All the events in the East,
продовження боротьби за свою гідність, за цілісність країни,
we go on fighting for the integrity of our country, unity of our country, justice for the country. Clearly, this is to be continued.
Очевидно, ця тема матиме продовження.
The topic is to be continued and to be covered by many filmmakers.
Я думаю, що тут питання
future generations. It's not about the competition. It's not about being better.
Це добре чи погано? Це надважливо. Тому я радий, що короткий термін на цю тему виходить цей продукт. Всі запитання або ж передачі якісь
у сфері
з цього приводу, я думаю, і автор розкаже, і дуже важливим буде наше, буде слово представників
документа. For the documentary and for the priests to support the inmates with them stories. For a person from abroad,
то, что в реальности произошло здесь, и донести через глаза, через камер, которые были на Майдане,
что-то, чтобы люди реально услышали и узнали то, что здесь произошло. И поэтому
появилась вот такая идея сделать Майдан глазами людей. Людей, которые стояли на Майдане, людей, которые выстояли, и своеобразный памятник создать тем, кто стоял, кто
выстоял и кто погиб. Вот это была цель этого фильма. Came the difficulties. I'm a filmmaker, I'm not a politician. I can not make speeches, so I would like to hear your questions. No questions. After the press briefing, maybe some commentary from the priests. From the clergy. Glory be to Jesus Christ, our Savior. Thank you very much for the invitation to participate in this press conference. We represent St. Michael's Golden Domed Monastery and Kiev Patriarchate. We had to be, it wasn't our choice, but we had to become participants and witnesses of the events depicted in the film. Monastic life should be peaceful, should be disciplined and orderly. That's the idea, but we had the gates, people calling, and people needing support, care, and shelter. And we did what we had to do as monks, as Christians, and we had to serve God and our people. When the St. Michael's Monastery received the Майдан people, our patriarch
монастиря були відкриті для того, щоб в них можна було влаштувати пункти першої допомоги.
Ordered opening of the gates and providing premises for the first aid and assistance, and the monks and the priests of our monastery participated in all that. We were constantly on duty and at prayer. We did it as priests and also as citizens, as simply people loving our country, our people. And still at St. Michael's Monastery, at every service, we raise our prayer for Ukraine. The main message is to ask God for peace, concordance in our country, for stopping the bloodshed and preservation of territorial integrity of Ukraine. Let's hope that this film that is made to cover truthfully the events in Kyiv of the period. We have to support and strengthen trust in the government and president and mass media in Ukraine. We hope that with God's will and God's help, that's where we have to invest our hope and our belief. But we have to stop jointly, to stop the events unfolding in our country.
It's not just in words that we are concerned and that we want to have peace in Ukraine. That's the real need, which is the priority in the demands of every Ukrainian. We do not want our people to die. St. Michael's Monastery continues to pray for those who perished in Maidan and who are now killed during the military actions in the east of Ukraine. But we especially pray for those who are alive, for those who need peace, to build the good future for our state. Let God help us in our intentions. Thank you all. Thank you, Father. Now I would like to give the flag of Sergei Nigayan to the group. I am the volunteer of Maidan. My name is Valentina, and it happened so that I was when the body of Nigayan was taken from Maidan, and that flag wasn't his personal belongings. I believe that Sergei would do the same, and he would have given this flag so that he travels all over the world with the film and talk about Ukraine. I believe there will be many legends, many beautiful stories about this flag. I do not know why it says Chernivtsi. Maybe some friend gave it to him. Maybe someone will see it and will tell the story. But that was Sergei's flag. And let this flag travel all over the world. Glory to Ukraine, glory to heroes. And now I would like to invite to show you this trailer to the film, and I remind that film will be like a business card of Ukraine. It will talk about values of Ukraine, about Maidan, the trailer. Maidan is the voice of people, and the voice of people is the voice of God, and people raised against the untruth. We will try now.
Зараз ми постараємося вирішити технічну проблему, а поки я запрошую
try to address the technical problem and now questions and to the producer, director of the film, to the minister of culture.
Центральна рада сотень Майдана вопрос владики.
And the question to the His Grace. Yesterday in St. Michael's, there was a burial ceremony for our person from Maidan, Petro, who was killed in the east. He was shot in the back.
Some artists singing
together with such politicians as Yarema in songs against Maidan. Do you believe that when they are singing with Yarema, it's like shooting into the back of Maidan? Yesterday in St. Michael's Golden Dome, the cathedral, we were burying Pavlo, who perished in the east of Ukraine. And always when you see such situation, especially when you know that the person was killed that way, any actions which could be compared to such a murder, they cause only negative reaction. But we believe that just like every person has a chance to get rid of sins, same way in case with people who possibly under the pressure of some circumstances, unconsciously, because they were not informed maybe, they support the actions which contradict everything that's happening in Maidan and now contradict the events of the liberation war in the east of Ukraine. We hope that God will make these people wise, those people who put all the efforts
and their deeds to Ukraine. Could you give more details about the film? Are these brief stories? Where will it be shown in Ukraine and in which countries when? If I understood your question correctly, what is the film about and where will it be shown? Now we are planning to have the first show in Toronto. There's a film festival in Toronto. We submitted the application to Toronto. We want to start from Canada and the American continent. I submitted from myself and from the team that was making it. I want to express my gratitude to Spilnabachenie, Ukrstream, Espresso, Channel 5, Tabor Productions, Radio Svoboda, all those and just guys who joined us, and we submitted to our American Oscar and to all other international big festivals, and to the group of awards that is part of American Oscar. Also, I believe that gradually, via Hollywood, I will be able to show this film all over the world, to tell the truthful story about Maidan, truthful story about common people who were in Maidan, not politicians. We have from doctors to sotniks to leaders of hundreds to people who were part of Automaidan. One of the characters is Ruslana. She just she failed to be here. She came at night from Mariupol. Till just a guy who lives in Maidan, Romka, a gypsy, and he still lives in Maidan. They tell the story what led them to Maidan, why them, despite the danger, despite understanding that they could be killed, they were standing there fighting for the integrity of the country where they grew up, where they were born. And now we'll take it to most of the major festivals and then we'll show it all over the world. I plan, and I'm grateful to Evgeny, who gives full support to this film, to organize the official premiere on the 21st of October with the support of American Embassy. That will be on the day when Maidan started. And the question to the whole crew, what makes it so special? What differs it from other documentaries? I am Lena Klebanova. I'm from Suspilnabachenie. Here's Kostya, who's from Ukrstream. And we have a big international team, crew. And the guys are asking, how was it to shoot? It was difficult. Emotionally, it was difficult. Because we all were in Maidan. We saw it with our eyes. The guys who are there, for them, they were crying. They were crying, the cameraman, those who were next to them. And really, it was very, very difficult. About 100 interviews we have there. About 50 people and parts of interviews are in the film, in the documentary, plenty of video material, about 500 hours of video material. So the shots that will be in the film are unique. I would like to give this to Kostya. I just want to add, what is the film about? That's chronology. That step after step, the history, which started from first people who came to protest on the 21st of November till the days when Yanukovych ran away, when the parliament approved the decision on resignation, on dismissal of Yanukovych. And we're trying to tell this story by the words of people. There's not a single word comment in this movie, just the words of witnesses, and we are trying to put it logically because we understand that it will be seen by people who saw some news about events in Ukraine, events in Maidan, and we wanted to create a document which will explain clearly to everyone what was happening here, why people went to protest, why there were such victims, and what have these people achieved. I call it not just documentary, but feature documentary film, because all these guys, men and women, everyone lived the whole life in Maidan. We all together, all those who were making this film, we were in Maidan together with them. We know them all personally, and we know that the whole world has to know what it started from. That's a huge vector that we turned in development of a new independent Ukraine. And these were people who did it. The people made this civilized choice, the choice of civilized life. And I want to say that again, we both in Maidan, at the front line, we showed that we can leave a big trace in the history of humankind. And it's not difficult for us. We virtually joined our efforts. No one was financing us. We took all the responsibility on ourselves. The world has to show all these events. I would like to also mention one thing. The film, for the first time, is made from the spiritual point of view. It was important to notice that it's not from politicians, but from people. That was very important to underscore here. And now Israel cannot find understanding with Arabs here in Maidan. Everyone was here, irrespective of religion, irrespective of their beliefs. Everyone was there, just like in any monastery. No one was looking at the belief. Everyone was equal. And that's important to show that all were one single nation, one single Ukraine. And we finished the film. I just remembered one thing. Volodya Parasyuk, when he was giving interview, his last interview, that's in the movie, he said, one guy gave me a ticket to a plane. When I went up, I saw Ukraine is so big, and Maidan is that small, and it was like a heart beating, and that heart gave the beginning to this new Ukraine, new society, where everyone, from young people to old people, they were there. And now, attempt number two. What you will see, it will be today on TV probably.
все поняли, и что такое единство, и что такое патриотизм, и что такое Бог.
Они поставят второй по гимну. Мы выпустили к фильму больше, чем 5 роликов. Вот это новый промо-трейлер. До этого вышли несколько роликов, которые есть на веб-сайте уже.
That's the new one.
Это старый промо-ролик, который более в хронологическом периоде рассказывал. Потом был сделан ролик, посвященный, в принципе, всем религиям,
to all religions that were at Maidan. There are unique shots there telling how all the priests were there under bullets. There are parts that show how they were there together with the guys at Institutska.
Велична історія нової української нації вкладена в 70-х років.
Tragic history of Ukrainian nation is an 80 minutes of documentary. Pray for Ukraine. Thank you all. Thank the Minister of Culture, thank the crew, the director of the film, the clergy, all those who helped to create what will become part of the contemporary Ukrainian history.